Hi, I'm Alistair Chapman, and I'm here at Sony's Digital Motion Picture Centre at Pinewood Studios in the UK. In this video, I'm going to take a look at BURANO's Fast Hybrid Autofocus system. Fast Hybrid AF includes features such as AI-enhanced subject tracking and touch-to-focus. To use Sony's autofocus, you need to use an E-mount lens. The sensor has 627 focal plane detection points, which cover 89% of the sensor. Inside the camera, there's a Sony autofocus processing unit that uses advanced AI techniques to allow the camera to accurately track objects and faces. The LCD screen is a touchscreen, and this can be used to control where the camera focuses simply by touching the screen. When shooting people, the AF has the ability to recognize humans and faces, and then prioritize them over anything else in the shot. When autofocusing on faces, the camera will prioritize the eyes of the person. To use the autofocus, you must ensure that if the lens you're using has an AF-MF switch, this is set to AF. On lenses with a focus ring that goes between auto and manual, the ring must be in the auto position. The green light next to the AF-MF switch will light green when the AF is enabled. When the AF is enabled, one of the easiest ways to use it is by touching the LCD screen. Simply touch the screen where you want the camera to focus, and it will focus at that point. And then if the camera is moving or the object is moving, the AF system will track it. To cancel the object tracking, touch the LCD screen in the top left corner where you'll see a tracking cancel symbol. The autofocus system is highly adjustable, and you may need to alter some of the settings to get the optimum performance for the type of content that you're shooting. The AF settings are found in the full menu under Shooting and Focus. The AF transition speed setting determines how quickly the autofocus distance can change. For fast-moving objects, you may want to set this to fast to allow the AF to quickly move from near to far. When set to slow, the speed at which the focus distance can change is much slower, and this might be preferable for drama, for interviews, where very rapid focus changes may look unnatural or distracting. If you're unsure, set this to a medium speed, such as 4. Personally, I tend to use 3 or 4, as I prefer the smoothness that the slower speeds give. The AF subject shift sensitivity determines how readily the autofocus will change between different objects. When this is set to 1 and locked on, the AF will remain fixed to the current AF subject and not change unless it can no longer see or recognize that target for an extended period. This can be very useful when other objects may be passing through the foreground of the shot, as the focus will stay fixed on your main target. When the shift sensitivity is set to 5 and responsive, the AF will readily switch to another target whenever the AF thinks that something else in the shot is now the main feature. For most general applications, 3 is a good choice. The focus area setting determines the area that the camera uses for the autofocus. Wide covers 89% of the full sensor area, so the AF will act across almost the entire image. Zone reduces the size of the AF area, and this smaller AF zone can be moved using the camera's thumbsticks if you only want the AF to focus on certain parts of your frame. Flexible spot is an even smaller zone that allows you to isolate the autofocus to just a very small area. Again, this can be moved using the thumbsticks to the part of the frame that you want the camera to keep in focus. The subject recognition AF setting allows you to choose between off for general autofocus that doesn't prioritize humans, or human priority AF, which will prioritize humans whenever one is identified in the shot. This causes the AF to focus on the person rather than other objects whenever one is identified in the shot. With human AF only, the autofocus will only focus when people are recognized in the shot. When there is no recognizable human in the shot in this mode, the AF will halt and wait until a human is again recognized. Whenever either of the human AF modes have been selected, whenever the camera recognizes a human face, the camera will put a white box around either the whole face, or where the camera can recognize the subject's eyes, a box around one of the eyes. Under this box, there'll be a bar. If this is not the face you want the camera to focus on, you can either touch on the face using the LCD that you want the camera to focus on, or use the camera's thumbsticks to move the orange bar to the face that you want. For most normal work, I tend to use human priority. For interviews or drama, I'll select human only. The touch function in MF setting allows you to touch the LCD screen to focus on an object when the AF switch on the camera is set to MF, but the lens itself remains set to AF. This can be useful for situations where your preference is to focus manually, but then suddenly you need to use the AF instead. When set to tracking AF, touching the LCD will activate the touch tracking AF, and the AF will then continue to track the touched object. When set to spot focus, the AF will focus on the spot you've touched on, and once in focus, reverts to manual focus. When AF assist is set to on, and you're using autofocus with a Sony E-mount lens, you can turn the lens's focus ring to determine which part of the shot should be in focus. This can be useful to pull focus between two different objects in the shot, with the AF ensuring that the focus is accurate. A further benefit of shooting with Sony E-mount lenses is the camera's electronic lens breathing compensation. When a compatible lens is used, the breathing compensation system will minimize any changes in the field of view that can occur as you focus the lens. The breathing compensation can be set to either auto or off in the full menu under Technical, Lens, and Breathing Compensation. On the left, we can see footage shot without breathing compensation, and on the right, the same lens with breathing compensation set to auto. It should be noted that breathing compensation will introduce a very minor crop into the image. As you can see, BURANO has some amazing tools to help you get great shots. The combination of IBIS, the variable ND filter, and Sony's amazing autofocus make it a great camera for fast mobile filming. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please watch the other videos in this series to learn more about how to use the Sony BURANO camera.